Hallelujah. Good morning, people of God. I welcome you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is Pastor Pascal. I welcome you to Daily Oil. Hallelujah. This is day three and it's Wednesday morning, and I want to ask you to call your family to come and join us. You're going to have a great time in the presence of the Lord this morning. God is going to speak to your heart. God is going to bless you. Hallelujah. And while you are doing that, let us just all begin to worship the Father right now. I want you to raise your hand from your house. Let's call on the rain of the Lord, the rain of the Spirit, to fall on us this morning. Hallelujah.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Oh yes.
Open the floodgates of heaven.
Let him open the floodgates of heaven over your life, over your finances, over your health, over your ministry, hallelujah, over your marriage. May the floodgates of heaven be unlocked as we pray, as we worship. Hallelujah.
Let it rain. Open the
The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness.
We want to see your glory this morning. We want to see your glory, Jesus. Pour yourself on us, Father. Reveal yourself to us, Jesus. Mighty Holy Ghost, reveal yourself to us in your power, in your glory. Reveal yourself, Lord. Reveal yourself, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Yes, Lord.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Lord, we ask this morning that you will open the floodgates of heaven, that you will fill our lives with your glory, Father. As we sing, as we worship, as we wait on you, as we partake of the word, reveal yourself. Floodgates of revelation, floodgates of healing, in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, hallelujah. Hallelujah, it's so beautiful to worship the Lord with you guys this morning once again. I welcome you to Daily Oil, hallelujah. And I believe that this has been a blessed time of us just learning more and more and more about the presence of the Lord in the person of the Holy Spirit. And this morning won't be any different. We're going to go deep in Him. If you are joining us for the first time, this program is all about the Holy Spirit. We have decided to dedicate this morning devotion to know more about the Holy Ghost. And this week we're learning about the Holy Spirit, getting to know more about the Holy Ghost. And our foundational scripture is John 14, verse 17. The Bible says, the Spirit of truth, the world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. Hallelujah. So the Holy Spirit can be known. And Jesus is telling us in this verse that we can know the Holy Spirit. On Monday, we saw that the Holy Spirit is God. Yesterday, we saw that the Holy Spirit is a person, or he has a personality. This morning, we are seeing that the Holy Spirit is the anointing. This thing we call the anointing. We sing songs like, anointing fall on me. And then we say, let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me. Anointing fall on me. That's because the Holy Ghost is the anointing. And I know the subject of the anointing has been a very intriguing subject in the body of Christ. Also the subject of a lot of controversies and confusion. Now, I don't stand here as the main authority on the subject, but I'm just going to share the little that the Lord has taught me so far on the anointing being the Holy Spirit. First of all, let's start. What is the anointing? You know, we find a little bit of what the anointing is in the book of Isaiah chapter 10, verse 27. The Bible says, it shall come to pass in that day that his burden will be taken away from your shoulders, and his yoke from your neck, and the yoke will be destroyed because of the anointing oil. So we see in this verse that there is something called the anointing oil, and that the anointing oil has the capacity to break yokes, to destroy yokes, and to remove burdens off the necks of people. So you see that if you want to remove a burden from your life, what you need is the anointing. Then here we even say the anointing oil. And I hope you begin to understand why we anoint people with oil. Why pastors have anointing oil services, while we sometimes also have anointing services where people get anointed with oil, and while sometimes when people are anointed with oil, they fall under the power of God. The anointing has the power to remove yokes. The anointing has the power to take away burdens from the shoulders of people. What is the anointing? We also find another powerful revelation of the anointing in the book of Psalm 92, verse 10. The Bible says, but my horn shall thou exalt like the horn of an unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Now, this talks of the service of God. And I'm sure you've come across somebody who said, yo, that guy is very anointed. Oh, that sister is very anointed. This is where we're getting it from. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. So Isaiah 10, 27 tells us that there is something called anointing oil that takes away burdens. And Psalm 92 verse 10 tells us that there's something called anointing oil that you can actually be anointed with. And they're all talking about the oil. All of them are talking about the oil. And this can also be misleading because you can think that the oil is where the power is. And that's why I decided to introduce you who is the anointing. The anointing is not the oil. The oil can be anointed. But the anointing is not the oil. The real anointing is the Holy Spirit. Now let's see the connection between the anointing and the oil. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13, the Bible says, so as David stood there among his brothers, Samuel took the flask of olive oil. He took the flask of olive oil he had brought and anointed David with the oil, and the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon David from that day on. Now you're beginning to understand. Samuel anointed David with olive oil, but something else happened that people didn't see. People saw the oil. Do you understand? People saw the oil being poured on Samuel, but no one knew actually what happened that day. The real thing that happened was that once the oil was dropped on David's head, the Holy Spirit came powerfully on David. And anything that you see David do was because he was anointed. But the anointing that he was anointed with was not just the oil, it was the Holy Ghost. The anointing, the real anointing. Well, let me give you another example. Acts 10:38, which I'm sure you're familiar with. And you know that God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. Then Jesus went around doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. Hallelujah. So you see that the oppression of the devil was not by the oil. It was because the Holy Ghost was, Jesus was anointed with the Holy Ghost. The real anointing, my brother, is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We can anoint you with oil, and then and there, you can be anointed. Meaning, the Holy Ghost responded to the oil and he came. But also, he might not come. I'm sure you've seen people being pour oil on them. Nothing changed really. Because you see, it's not about the oil. It's about the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Then Luke 4 verse 18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Why? Because he has anointed me to preach. So the anointing to preach is actually the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Ghost that comes on people. And then when the Holy Ghost comes on a person, we now say that person is anointed to preach. What is the anointing? The anointing is the Holy Ghost coming on you. When the Holy Ghost comes on you, he empowers you to do something that naturally you would not be able to do. And that coming of the Holy Ghost on a person, on a human vessel, and that manifestation of the gift of the Holy Ghost, when the Holy Ghost comes on a prophet, for example, the prophet starts seeing things that naturally he wouldn't be able to see. When the Holy Ghost comes on a singer, the singer starts singing songs that start touching people in the way that another person will sing the same song and nothing will happen. When the Holy Ghost comes on a teacher, he starts explaining the word in a way that makes so much sense that people start understanding scriptures they couldn't understand before, and they ask themselves, is it the same Bible I'm reading? That supernatural touch that a human being experiences is what we call the anointing. The anointing is the act of the Holy Ghost coming on a human vessel and empowering that human vessel to do something that he himself would not have been able to do had he not received that enabling by the Holy Spirit. That is what the anointing is. Hallelujah. Now, I'm not saying that we don't believe in anointing people with oil. As a matter of fact, there are many scriptures that validate the fact that we should anoint people with oil. God uses it. In the book of Mark 6 verse 13, we see that, and they cast out many demons and healed many sick people, anointing them with olive oil. So the disciples were using the anointing oil to heal the people. We even see that, Paul's handkerchief were also healing people. We believe in that. James 5 verse 14 says, are any of you sick? You should call for the elders of the church to come and pray over you, anointing you with oil and in the name of the Lord. So you see that in the New Testament, we talk about the anointing as well. People are anointed with oil. We also anoint people with oil. But I want to tell you something this morning. The real oil, the real power is not the oil. Because if you know very well, that is oil you buy in the shop. And that same oil you buy in the shop, another person buys the same oil and goes and cooks with the same oil. So are you now cooking the Holy Ghost? So the anointing is not, that is just a symbolism, a representation, because oil represents also healing. And I think 2 weeks ago, I thought on the fact that the shepherds were using oil to protect the sheep. So oil was used to chase flies away, and flies represent evil spirits. That's why the Holy Ghost also goes with the oil, because the oil represents a form of protection. The oil represents a form of chasing evil spirits away. The oil represents also a form of empowering. Remember, when you have maybe a rusted wheel and you're trying to get it to unrust, you use oil. So oil represents this capacity to make things to work. So the Holy Ghost comes when you put engine oil, the engine starts working. So the Holy Ghost is just a representation of what happens when the Holy Ghost comes on a person. When the Holy Ghost comes on a person, things start working, simply put. The ministry starts working. The preaching starts working. The singing starts working. Whatever you are doing, when the Holy Ghost comes on you, it starts working. That's why when the Holy Ghost came on Jesus, Jesus had the capacity to preach, but it was not working. When the Holy Ghost came on him that day, he became able to do it. And that's why he said, the Spirit of God is upon me because he has anointed me. I did not anoint myself. I was anointed by the Holy Ghost to do what I'm doing. And that's why Jesus told his disciples in the book of Luke 24, verse 49, behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high. What is the anointing? Endowment with power from on high. Endowment with power from on high. That is what the anointing is, simply put. Is that the Holy Ghost comes and he empowers you to do something. Many times I'm preaching and the Holy Ghost comes on me and I start saying things I didn't plan to say. My listeners are hearing it the same time as I'm hearing it. And many times these are words, sometimes the words are already, the sentence is already made. Like you would think, Pastor thought about this. I never thought about it. I heard the sentence the way you heard it. Why? The anointing comes and it enables you. Hallelujah. Therefore, Acts 1:18, which I'm sure all of you will know, the Jews shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, or when the Holy Ghost comes upon you, and you shall be my witnesses. So the Holy Ghost coming upon you will empower you to become a witness. Maybe you are wondering why you are unable to serve God and work for God. The key is the anointing. And the anointing is the Holy Spirit. So don't just take the Holy Ghost as speaking in tongues. No. The Holy Ghost is empowerment, enablement. Maybe you are working in the church, whichever department you are working in, trust God to anoint you. Trust God to anoint you so that you can be able to do the things you're supposed to do. It is the anointing that makes the difference. When I teach, if I'm not anointed, I can't do well. When I preach, if I'm not anointed, it won't work. Anything you do without the anointing is heavy, is hard, is difficult, is just, it makes people fall asleep, simply put. The anointing is the secret, my brother. Every great man of God you know them because of the anointing. Every great woman of God you know them not because they are talented, not because they went to school. There are people who went to school better than them. But the reason why you know them is because an ability comes on them at certain times, and they start saying things that a human being cannot say naturally. They start doing things that are not doable by a human being. That is what I'm trusting God for my personal life, that he will continue anointing me more. And I'm trusting God that he will continue anointing you. Hallelujah. And you know the anointing is not the oil. It's the Holy Spirit. So don't go for the anointing of oil only. Go for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, not with oil, with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all those who were under the control of the evil one. That is the real power. The anointing of the Holy Ghost brings results. The anointing, listen, I can pour oil on your head until you become oily. But that is not going to change anything. But you can be sitting there in your house without a drop of oil, but then the drop of the Holy Ghost touches you, and then everything changes about your life. So I go more for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Go for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I know African people like things they can see. That's why we buy anointing oil, and we don't spend time with the Holy Ghost. That's why we buy holy water, and we don't spend time with the Holy Ghost. I'm here to tell you this morning, the real power is the Holy Spirit. Go for the real power. And the real power, you don't need to buy it. Jesus paid the price. He said, I will send it. You just receive it. He says, receive. You shall receive power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you. So you don't need to buy the power. You just need to receive the power. And it will be yours. Believe and receive. Believe and receive. And you will see tremendous things start happening in your life. I'm talking now to all the pastors. I'm talking to all the Basenta leaders. I'm talking to all the Basonta leaders. I'm talking to anybody serving God in any department in the church. The key to success in ministry is not talent. It's more than talent. It's the anointing. The Bible says it's not by might, it's not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. Don't try to impress people. Try to be anointed. Continue to pray, Lord, anoint me. Lord, anoint me afresh. The Bible says, my horn shall exalt like the horn of an unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Lord, fresh oil. Fresh oil, not the old stuff. Fresh oil every day, Lord. Give me fresh oil. And that's what we're talking about, daily oil. It's daily anointing, fresh anointing to face the challenges of the day. Hallelujah. You are receiving it now in the name of Jesus. I see the Lord anointing you. The Bible says, he who comes after me is greater than me. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with power. Meaning Jesus Christ is the one that is now anointing people. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you will anoint me. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you will anoint all my viewers. Anoint us all, oh Jesus. Anoint us with the supernatural power of God so that we can serve you effectively. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, you are blessed. I hope that you've enjoyed this series. Right now, I want to lead somebody to accept Jesus. If you are watching this program today, maybe somebody told you about daily oil. Maybe you were invited by a friend on Facebook, and that's how you came to watch the program. I want to encourage you today to give your life to Jesus. You don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. You don't know what the future holds. You only have today. Right about now, right where you are sitting, all standing, I want you to lift your two hands to heaven and pray this prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus, I surrender my life to you today. Forgive me my sins. Wash me with your blood. I believe you died for me. On the third day you rose again that I might be justified. Right now, I believe my sins are forgiven. I'm justified by your blood. I'm saved. I'm restored. I'm born again. I am free from the power of sin to serve the living God. Thank you, Jesus, for receiving me. Thank you, Jesus, for restoring me. Thank you, Jesus, for forgiving me. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Well, friend, if you've prayed that prayer with us, the Son of God has entered your heart. Let us know where you join us from. Send us a message on Facebook. We'll be able to contact you. Hallelujah. And send you a gift. Praise God. Right now, I want to thank all of you for tuning in this morning. It's always a joy. I'm glad by your comments you guys are always sending to encourage us. Please keep them coming. Bless you richly. Hallelujah. Don't forget, we are meeting again tomorrow. And later today, around about 4 o'clock, we're going to have fire hour. Don't miss it. Be there. Join us. Come, let's pray. Hallelujah. It's prayer time. Join us in prayer. Let's call on the name of the Lord. Amen. If there is a change, we'll let you know. praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is Pastor Pascal reminding you that we are alive to give life. Hallelujah. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Same place, same time. Praise God.